Facebook is the most used social network in the world. With over 2.2 billion active users, why wouldn't you want to use this platform to advertise your product or service? In this video, I'm going to talk you through how to advertise on Facebook in 8 straightforward steps. I'll also share a template for planning a Facebook advertising campaign at the end. To start, I'm going to answer some questions you might have. I've never used Facebook before, will I be able to advertise? Firstly, congratulations for not getting sucked into the Facebook hype. And secondly, yes, of course you can still use Facebook advertising. It's completely different to Facebook for personal use, although you will have to set up a personal account in order to get started with advertising. My target audience is B2B. Can I still advertise on Facebook even though my audience isn't B2C? Absolutely. Once logged into Facebook, it continues to collect your data in the background, even if the app or site is closed on your phone or browser. Think of how many people log into Facebook at work. We all do it. I don't want the whole of Facebook to see my ad. Is there a way to only show my ads to certain types of people? Yes, the targeting function on Facebook advertising is great. You can really pinpoint what type of person you want to target. If you have any questions for me, just watch this video. I may answer it in the video and leave a comment. The first step with Facebook advertising is, of course, getting your Facebook ad account set up. In order to do so, you will need a personal Facebook account, a company page linked to your personal Facebook account, and you will need to set up an ad account. To do this, go to your Business Manager settings in Facebook. Under the People and Assets tab, click on Add Accounts. On the right-hand side of the page, select Add New Ad Account. Choose one of the three options: Claim Ad Account, Request Access to an Ad Account, or Create a New Ad Account. The next important step before you get started with Facebook advertising is to install the Facebook Pixel tag to your site. This way you can track when people come to your site from your ads. Facebook lets you choose what your marketing objective is for your ad campaign. The different objective options are reach, brand awareness, engagement, video views, messages, catalog sales, traffic, app installs, lead generation, conversions, and store visits. Most of these are self-explanatory, but here's a quick summary of each. This gets your ad out in front of as many eyes as possible. This enables Facebook to get your ad out to people who are most likely to be interested in your product or service. Get likes, comments, and shares on a post, get events, responses, or page likes. There are 3 types of ad format that fall under this campaign objective. Get more people to view your video. Get more people to send messages to your business. Automatically show items from your catalog based on your target audience. A traffic ad sends more people to a destination on or off Facebook, for example, a website landing page. Get more people to install your app. Drive more sales leads from people already interested in your business. Drive more valuable actions on your Facebook page, in Messenger, or on your website. Get more people nearby to visit your store or business. Facebook allows you to advertise around a range of different things, from text to imagery to video. Here's a summary of all the different types of ads you can post. The wide range of ad types means you can choose what sort of ad you think suits your target audience, your product or service. For example, if you run a clothing store, a carousel ad could work perfectly for you. If you run a video production company, a video ad is probably the right type of ad for you. Organising your first festival? An event response ad will work a treat. You can use common sense when making this decision, although it's also a good idea to split test and see what ad type works best for your company. Boosted posts don't fall under ad types in Facebook Ads Manager. Instead, you can boost posts directly from your business's Facebook page. Boosting a post means putting a bit of money behind a post to get it in front of a wider audience. While you can choose a target audience for a boosted post, you can't choose what action you wish your audience to take. For example, you may be looking for people to visit a website page, but Facebook may decide to optimize your ad for engagements, so you can get loads of post likes and no website visits. It's best to stick to running a proper Facebook ad through Ads Manager, as you can get more targeting options and can decide what your marketing objective is. Facebook is, in my opinion, the best platform to use when it comes to targeting. You're given an array of options to target people based on things like geography, their job role, their online activity or interests. You can even choose which postal code they live in and what school or university they went to or go to. It's important to spend a lot of time on this part of the ad process. You want to get this right to ensure you target your dream customer and you don't waste money getting clicks from people who will never buy your product or service. The key thing to remember when it comes to targeting is that you want to target each stage of the buying cycle. You want to target people who are already considering buying your product or service at the same time as targeting those who don't even know you exist. The way to target people at different stages of the buying cycle is to create different ads within your ad groups. You have no idea where members of your audience are within the buying cycle, so you need to ensure your ads reach out to each stage. Once you have different ads focusing on the different stages of the buying cycle, you can check back to see which ads are most successful and which may need tweaking. If you're solely focusing on retargeting, with help from the handy Facebook Pixel, you can write your ads exclusively to reach out to the deal stage of the buyer's journey. Deciding on a budget for your Facebook ads can be hard. How do you know what to spend if you've never run ads on Facebook before? A good idea when starting a campaign on Facebook is to start with a trial amount. For example, set your total budget to £50 and see how far it gets you. Be careful not to set a daily budget with no end date if you don't want to spend all of your company's money. Also, be wary that Facebook cheekily sets the total budget to £350 as standard. Nice try, Facebook. So now you know how to set up an ad. But how do you know how to set up a good ad? Here are some tips that are vital in ensuring your ad performs to the best of its ability. Use simple, bold imagery with little or no text on the image. If you have too much text on your image, Facebook will rarely show your ad. Simple and bold stands out, and if you're thinking about running an ad with no image at all, just don't bother. Set a goal for your campaign. You need a goal to ensure that you know what the aim of the ad is. How are you going to know if your campaign has been successful if you don't know what you're measuring? Use video. Video ads grab the audience's attention and are very effective on Facebook. Although always bear in mind that only decent videos are effective. Don't post a video ad for the sake of posting a video ad. Make it look sleek and professional and reflect your business the right way. Don't go it alone. Get people to read over your ad ideas to ensure they make sense and look good. Spend time on audience targeting. If you don't want to waste money, spend as much time as necessary on targeting the right audience. Facebook allows you to delve deep into this, so make the most of it. Take risks. Funny ads work. Be brave and ensure your text and imagery fits with your tone of voice. The next key step to running ads on Facebook is measuring what's worked and what hasn't, and why. Facebook allows you to view lots of stats around your ads. Always check back to see which ads have brought you the most clicks, for example. You can then pause the ads that aren't working and work on the ads that are. It's essential to install the Facebook Pixel so you can track conversions and retarget your audience. Measuring success and failure also means you can report back to your manager and show progress and give suggestions for future ad campaigns. I hope you found this video useful. If you'd like to know more about social advertising, or if you'd like access to my social advertising strategy plan, just leave me a comment. Please also like the video, or dislike it if you must, and subscribe to the 4-Minute Tech channel. Thank you for watching.